Castleview, and welcome to the first in our assembly series relating to the values. I'm really excited today to be talking about two of our values, be present and take notice. And I think the reason I'm excited to talk about these particular values is because I think we do these really well whilst we're in school at Castleview. However, how are we doing this well when we're at home? I think in order for us to understand that, we really need to understand what these two values mean. To be present is to be in the here and the now, to be living in the moment. And at home, this might mean putting away your mobile phone for a half an hour. It might mean turning the TV off. It might mean just having a conversation with someone in your household. It might mean doing something now that perhaps you have been putting off for tomorrow or the next day. I have certainly been doing that a lot, and I'm sure a lot of us can be saying the same. And then there is take notice, which for me is three different things. It's taking notice of yourself, how you're feeling, taking notice of those around you, people in your home, your household, and also taking notice about what's happening around you. So first of all, taking notice of yourself. This is actually a really important thing to be able to do, to acknowledge how you're feeling, and when you're waking up in the morning, just having that moment to tap into what's going on inside your mind. I want to cast your mind back to Mental Health Awareness Week, where Mrs. Clark and our pastoral team worked tirelessly to help us understand the importance of mental health. And they had this little checkpoint, which I'm going to show you now, just to help us remember how important mental health is. Take a look. So whether or not your heart is feeling yellow or blue or green or red for that day, just remember to be kind to yourself, and however you're feeling, that's okay. And then there's the importance of noticing others around you. How many times have you actually just stopped and noticed the people in your home? Perhaps you've noticed that they need a hug or a bunch of flowers, or they need something just left on the doorstep. How many of you have noticed the power of the words thank you, even for just something really silly like making you a cup of tea in the morning? I am noticing my students all of the time. I'm noticing the ones that are working really, really hard on Teams. I'm also noticing the ones that aren't there. I'm noticing all the teachers that are working hard, and they are noticing you as well, hopefully for all of the right reasons. We're just going to take a minute now to have a look at some of the ways we've noticed each other this academic year.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. And our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock them so hard. And it's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're...
I'm going to show you a picture now, and I'm going to give you 5 seconds to see if you can notice the police car. Off you go. Did you find it? This time, I'm going to ask you a different question, and I want you to have another look. I'm going to give you a little bit more time. This time, I want you just to tell me what you notice about this picture. Have a go. Did you notice the blind man? Did you notice the man on his bike drinking water? How is it that that time around we noticed so much more? It's because you weren't limited to that one thing I had asked you to do. And because you weren't limited, the actual expectations of you were boundless, and that makes all the difference. And how is this relevant now to your learning? What have I showed you that picture for? The whole point of school is for us to develop you as people and to make sure that you are the absolute best human being that you can be. That's our job. And so we ask you to push yourself, we ask you to take notice, and we ask you to be present, because actually they're the attributes of the most successful people in the world and the people around us. to be successful, you have to take notice when someone needs a thank you, or they need a hug, or they need some support, for example. To be successful, you have to take notice when you have more to give. So as we move forward into the final half term of this academic year, I would like you just to take a minute to think about what more could you be giving? And just to finish up, I really just want to say thank you to all of you, all of the students and the teachers at Castleview, who are doing the right thing every day, who are taking notice and who are being present, because that is making all of the difference to our school. So really, really well done. We will see you next week for another Values Assembly. And in the meantime, take care.
Hi guys, something that I've noticed while I've been in lockdown is how much I've relied on exercise and doing my daily walks and my HIIT workouts just to keep me motivated.
Since lockdown, I can hear the birds singing no matter what time of day it is, so much nicer than the normal traffic I hear on the A130.
Hello Castleview, what I've noticed during lockdown is how my dog likes to spend time with me when I'm setting work for you guys.
One thing I've noticed in lockdown is the kindness of my neighbours. Before all of this happened, I didn't even know their names. Now we're all on first name terms, say hello to each other in the street, and it's a really nice environment to be in.
One thing I've noticed during lockdown is that I have a love for being outside. Being a PE teacher, I get to spend a lot of time outside in all different weather conditions. Thankfully, the weather during this pandemic has been great, and the garden's had a makeover. I've gone on lots of bike rides with my sons, and now the golf courses are open.